brown sugar.
That is fresh Amish-made brown sugar.
Amish-made, huh? Well, before I figured you was going to get some rye or something, some grain, but...
Well, you think about it, we're pushing kind of later in the season right now, so things are getting kind of scarce. I mean, look how much issue we had finding corn.
Oh, I know it, man. I tell you.
I've got this at a really good deal. There's no artificial nothing in that.
Let's see how it tastes. Yeah. Damn. You can tell it's very, very fresh and very good. I understand the concept, but that's awful damn bland. Just sugar, water, and yeast, you know.
I want you to try. And we'll see if we can do something similar to it, but I think it's going to be something neat and unique to everybody.
So you got some with you or something?
Yeah, I brought a little bottle with me.
We'll jerk it out. Damn, I'm cold. Let's warm up.
Get your horn of that.
And if you like something, I don't mind trying to make it, you know. Damn. Boy, it's got a damn good taste, but boy, it evaporates off the tongue awful fast. What in the hell proof is that?
That's 160 proof.
160 proof? Well, this spiced liquor evaporates off your tongue really, really fast at this high proof, but it leaves all the flavor behind. There's so many different flavor notes going on in this stuff, and that's what I like about it. I can't believe this stuff's 160 proof. You know what I'm picking up on the most? Some kind of damn sassafrasy or birchy like.
On my side, I'm getting kind of more of like a cinnamony vanilla. Mm-hmm. Nutmeg kind of flavor. You know, I don't really know what spices are in this spice liquor, but man, they're amazing. Something we did is do it in a clear version instead of a dark version. You know how we done our amaretto? We didn't really go by what amaretto was made out of.
No.
We kind of done our own thing, you know. Something we do the same thing with this, and whatever spices we decided we want to
put in it.
That's entirely up to us. I think that'll sell good.
If we can make it 160 proof and be that damn smooth without burning somebody's guts out, I can't wait to see it happen. That's a damn good item, but look. We ain't got no damn system that'll run 160 proof. The rig that we're running on right now won't reach 160 proof. So me and Jerry, we're gonna head on into the steel site and take a look at this rig and just come up with something to give this thing a facelift, because the way it sits right now, it's never gonna make it.
You know, I'm thinking we're gonna have to have probably multiple jar rigs to get up that high proof. Plus, I'm thinking if we're gonna make it a clear,
yeah,
we need to introduce that spice as it's coming through.
Yeah, we got to do that because we don't want to mix spices and stuff in these wood barrels.
Mm-mm. You know, we had real good luck when we done our jars on our column, how they was all going vertical.
Yeah.
What if we just actually replace this thing here?
In other words, put like a small column type up here?
Yeah.
Me and Jerry come to the conclusion, we're going to go back to what we know how to do. We're going to incorporate a small jar rig to this steel. It accomplishes higher proof. It, you can add flavors into the jars and infuse a high proof alcohol as it comes through the jar rig.
We just come right off of here and go right beside this flue and then come off the top of whatever we do here and bring it right down here.
Yep.
We're just gonna build pretty much a cap jar rig to set right on top of this barrel seal. This flue will help keep them jars warm, keep it trucking and right on and running.
That sounds like a winner, winner, chicken dinner to me. You know, I feel like me and Jerry can make a lot of money on this if we make it turn out right. Because, you know, people's wanting premium liquor these days, and they don't mind spending the money, but it's got to be good.
We'll probably have to break it up a little bit more as we pour it.
Yeah, we can do it. One damn thing for sure, it'll make alcohol.
A few pieces of scrap copper here if you want to go ahead and start laying out for some caps to go on there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, me and Jerry, we're working on some overproof spiced liquor. We've got to fabricate a jar rig onto our steel pot to make the proof up higher.
I would say just a little bit bigger than those.
I reckon. This is a mini column with six small jars to infuse this flavor with these spices for the rum. Every time the steam and the alcohol flows through one of these jars, it's going to redistill and up that proof just a little bit more through each and every jar.
You know, I think if we hit this 160 proof of this stuff, I think we stand a good chance of making a lot of money with it.
I do too.
Pirates used to drink that real high proof stuff, so.
We got a lot of folks in the world that still think they're pirates.
Yeah, that's for a fact.
It's salted there.
Mm-hmm.
That's it, I say it's salted.
Yeah, that's a little spot here. I didn't really like the way it looked. So I'll fix it. And that's more gooder.
More gooder?
Yeah.
That damn, you burn it up, didn't you?
It's actually a little something for you.
Look at that.
Come your little graduation cap.
Oh.
I've schooled you for so many years, it's time for you to graduate.
I heard that. You know, I've been messing with jar rigs for years, you know, and I've seen how efficient these things was. So this is a facelift, so to speak, to this rig that we've been running. And that go in yonder.
Right. This is probably gonna be one of our smaller jar rigs we've ever built, huh?
I'd say so.
Hold the jar if you will. Let me get the other way.
We're gonna replace the existing cap to set this jar rig on top. That way we can even take it off when we don't need it and just run the steel the way we usually do, or we can just throw it back in place when we have an order for a higher proof type of flavored alcohol that we need to run. It's no end in sight when it, you know, comes to the possibilities of building stuff to make your proof even higher.
Well, all we got left to do now is just get this sucker to the wood, grab us some spices.
Stick them in, hook the arm up to the condenser.
We're off the race.
Go, son. Ready to load these jars up, Jerry?
I'm ready to do it, too.
We got our spices here. Today, me and Jerry are going to try to make our overproof spiced liquor. I'm going to skin this ginger root a little.
Skin her back. That'll release all them flavors out of there, huh?
Yeah, boy. Do you even like ginger at all?
Yeah, a little bit. Not much.
Not much? Take and chew that little bit of ginger up. Stuff is good, Johnny. Try it. Seriously, you gotta try your spices. Just try it. It's ginger. It's strong, ain't it?
Yeah, we only need a little bit of that.
160 proof alcohol is hard to drink by itself. You gotta put a good bit of these spices in there, Jerry.
How it comes out of a jar rig, it's gonna be good.
Me and Jerry just got finished building our jar rig to keep that proof real high. It'll be able to transfer those spices and flavors over into our liquor. Oranges.
Oranges.
Good old ginger root. Normally we wouldn't sell 160 proof, but a lot of people like a real high proof spice liquor. Just a little bit of each spice goes a long way, and at the end you have a really good flavorful alcohol. So that's gonna be Flavor Town down USA right there. With all the spices being incorporated into this, I believe people will buy it and be able to enjoy it no matter how high that proof is.
Oh, look at that teamwork, son.
Look at that.
Let's get this pumped over, get this little heat going.
I need you to pull on that like you ain't never did before now.
She's rolling.
Damn, Jerry, that's good, boy.
Got a good flavor to it, don't it?
Whew, shoot ya. Yeah, I'm glad we got this damn water-powered fan in here that's working good. It won't be long now. We got a little bubbles.
We got a little bubble action. Getting some sweat in here. Look at it starting to cry down the sides right there.
It sure is.
You see the flavors in there just dancing around?
They are. They're mixing. Just get her to climb on up. You know, there's six jars incorporated with this jar rig, and watching this jar rig run and sweat and condense like the first time ever, time, man. We are fixing to have some spiced liquor come out of this worm. I can't wait. It's gonna be nutmeggy, vanilla-y, peppercorny, and ginger rooty.
A little orange citrus to it.
With a little orange in it.
She's in the water.
She's in the water now.
Shouldn't be long now.
There she comes. All right. Oh.
There it is.
Our main goal is to be 160 proof. So we need our heads to be pretty damn high so we can maintain that 160 proof throughout the run. That's where we got to stop at and keep this this spiced liquor at 160 proof for selling. Let's dump them out, boys. You ready? Let's see what we got.
Here.
Holy damn. About 171.
I'll take that.
That's pretty good.
All right.
Is that pretty?
I love the fact that it's clear. People's gonna eat that up. Still holding that good flavor?
That evaporate off your tongue in a damn hurry. And them flavors is coming through there like no other. She's warm.
She's warm. That's...
That'll warm your damn guts up, won't it?
Flavors are so strong after that stuff dissolves.
It's just right.
And it's clear. I love it.
It's nice. Yeah, you know, it's taking a lot for me and Jerry to get to this point of running this stuff. The dogs come in on us. We run into the damn hunters, but it's well worth it. This stuff is on down point, son. I think we've hit it, man. I think we've got some of the best alcohol we've ever run here.
Get the heck out of here and go see if we can find us some hunters.
Yep, go get them boys took care of. Try to get us some sold.